my brother Phil and I, they were our first biggest and biggest influences, and they were our role models as well, you know. And I tried everything to sound like Bruce, and Phil tried everything to sound like Hank. And they were fantastic people to follow, and they still are. Well, I played in Royal Festival Hall in London in January of this year, and Bruce came to the show. So it was like, you know, it's almost a feeling like your life comes full circle when you get to know your childhood heroes, you know.
Now, I can detect a little accent in your voice, which has probably been developing over the years, because you spend most of your time living in Nashville.
Yeah, I've lived there for 15 years. I've also lived in LA. I lived in San Francisco. I lived in England twice. And
So it's international.
It's kind of international. Yeah. I remember when I was a kid, my mother always drumming it into me, look, slow down, don't speak so quickly, you know, things like that. And I noticed frequently going to Europe that if I spoke a little slower, even people who couldn't speak English, they could understand it, especially Italians. So I ended up, you know, changing the way I speak just purely so I can communicate with people. And I try to learn a little bit of the language wherever I am, you know. And my wife was born in Sydney, but she's Korean, so I learned a little bit of Korean so I can talk with her family. And, you know, I've just been to China, Japan, Hong Kong, Singapore, Thailand. And so, you know, I'm speaking a little, you know, hello and thank you and that kind of stuff in many languages, including Russian and stuff.
Take us to Nashville. What's it like being a guitarist in Nashville? Because, you know, I'm probably thinking it's the stereotype where it's all country music and country music artists.
Well,
is it like that?
It's Music City. You can see anything there, Belinda. You can go to the opera. Or you can go to the Opry, or you can go to the Country Music Hall of Fame, or, you know, you can go to a classical recital, you can go to a jazz club. It's got everything. It really is Music City. And it's a great community of artists and people. And, you know, there's a lot of big business going on there. It's Dell Computers World Headquarters. You know, the National Guard is based there. It's a diverse town and is growing quickly. I've lived there for 15 years, and you hardly recognize downtown now. You know, it's just so built up, and so many apartments and new buildings and massive convention centers and new hotels. And but it's still Music City, you know.
25 past 10, Tommy Emmanuel in the studio. He's playing at the Perth Concert Hall this evening. If you've got tickets, this is a kind of like a little sneak peek of that, I guess. We are Facebook Live, I should mention, if you're anywhere near your technology.
Get on your computer.
And Tommy's giving you a wave. So if you're, jump on ABC Perth's Facebook page and it's all Facebook Live, you can see Tommy up just before the show tonight. Mm-hmm. When you do the shows, and you do so many, I mean, sometimes you're in the mood, sometimes you're not. It's a performance, obviously, but do you sort of walk on and that's the show, and even if it's not, you're not feeling great that night, what do you do?
Okay, well, you know, that's a really good question. You're always planning on the magic arriving, you know. When you play, it's like you're pouring everything you can into it, and you're trying as hard as you can. But you also, there's another dimension, which is something that reaches out and touches people who hear it, and you know it when it's happening, and you're always hoping that it'll arrive. If on my worst night, I have a good repertoire of good arrangements and good songs, I know I can stand on those. Even on my worst night, I can still play what I would consider a show of good quality and integrity. I'm always improvising and trying new things on stage. I don't plan too much because I want it to be totally the unknown when I go out there. The only thing I know is that my songs work, my arrangements work. I've spent time making them that way. And I'm dedicated to my instrument and to the public. When I go on stage, I give everybody as much as I can. And there's two reasons for that. That's how I am as a person, and I want to come back.
Yeah.
You know, it's important.
Great approach.
Yeah, well, I think so. But, you know, every night is a little different, and I purposely don't write a set list and work out, you know, I don't think it through too much. I just decide at the last minute, what am I going to start with? Okay, and then once I bolt out of the gate like that, I'm off, you know. And sometimes I'll experiment. Like, for instance, the second time I played in Sweden, I can still remember this, it was so overwhelming, the response of the audience, the first tour, that I said, I'm going to experiment. I'm going to start with a slow song tonight instead of coming out of the gates. You know,
bells and whistles.
Exactly. Yeah, really slamming and jamming. So I started the show in Gothenburg with a ballad, and the audience went crazy after. I said, wow, this is, wish I had this every night. This would spoil me, you know. And, you know, my last concert was last Saturday night, and that was in Auckland at the Town Hall. And that was another one of those magic nights where when the show was over and I went back to my hotel, I said, okay, the next show's in Perth. It's going to have to be good to beat that one, you know. Did a review of the show, and I kept it because I was so moved. He wrote in such a way that, he was an artist himself.
Oh, he'll be back. He'll be there tonight.
I'm sure. I hope so. Yeah.
Can we have a listen to something, just a little taste maybe of what we can expect tonight?
How about, let's see, I kind of thought, and here I'm here at the ABC. How about if I play something that I wrote for the ABC back in the 70s?
Really?
The ABC had a television series called Countrywide.
Oh, yes.
And they came to me to write a theme. And this is in the mid-70s. This is what I wrote, as the composer intended. Countrywide.
Thank you so much. I recognized it as soon as you started.
Oh, thanks.
Yes, I've got it. Do you practice much?
All the time.
Do you?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. You have to. You're trying to improve yourself every day, you know. And some days you're slower than others, you know. Some days you feel like you've got weights hanging on your fingers. And then other days it's like a magic carpet ride, you know, and 'cause we are different every day, you know, and you know those days where you feel a little slow and you don't want to try too hard.
Never.
No. I'm sure.
Hey, can I just mention, and I didn't mention this, Chet Atkins has he awarded you, I think, think that's the terminology. You're one of five certified guitar players.
Yeah, there are three of us left. And tonight, ladies and gentlemen, will be the world surplus because the gentleman who's on tour with me is one of the other ones. His name is Steve Wariner, and he's a great singer and a great guitar player from Nashville. And so this is Steve's first time in Australia, and I'm so proud to have him on the show. So there's only one other, and that's John Knowles, and he's back in Nashville right now. But so there'll be a world surplus of CGPs on stage tonight.
It was so lovely to have you in the studio.
Thanks,
Tommy
thanks
Emmanuel,
me.
He's playing tonight at the Perth Concert Hall. When does it all kick off, Tommy?
8 o'clock.
8 o'clock tonight at the Perth Concert Hall. Mm-hmm. And two, not one, but two certified guitar players
exactly.
on stage at the Perth Concert Hall tonight.
Yeah.
Hopefully a little bit of magic created.
Wouldn't it be great?
Yeah.
All right.
All the best.
Let's get the mojo.
Tommy Emmanuel in the studio, ABC.